Hold up a couple jets one by one.
Are we doing all of them?
No, just some of them.
Let's get all the cool ones.
We are filming.
Okay. They squished it. I would be so mad.
What, if you paid 56 shipping and they...
Yeah, and then they squished it.
All right.
Dun, 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 dun! Hi, everybody. BeanMeister22 here. Let me do that one more time. Drum roll. Dun, 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 dun. This is my last of the Daron BestLock passenger jets. Finally! As you guys know, I have done videos on all of these Daron BestLock jets, and number one, they are horrible quality. Number two, they all come with a minifig that looks identical to every other one, and it doesn't fit in the jet. It's too big. Yeah, it's horrible, right? Every one of these is totally BestLock quality. There has been an occasional misformed brick. Yeah, I've done a lot of these. They have gapping problems. There's smudges and dirt and grease on the bricks from the manufacturing process. There's blemishes. Horrible. But it's BestLock quality, which is horrible. And at this point, let me say, it's funny, because every once in a while, someone will send me a PM or leave a comment saying, well, BestLock is good quality. Are you insane? BestLock is not good quality. BestLock is low quality, but for a low price. And I can live with that. But when you order a BestLock Sherman, and the rubber tank treads are already broke, and you have misformed bricks, and it's not just the Sherman, there was misformed bricks, and I think one set I had of maybe 20 or 15 or 18 BestLock sets, only one did not have a problem. It was a small little tiny tube set. Other than that, they've all had a little problem. They all have gapping problems and clutching problems. That's just a BestLock set. And I'm not really saying BestLock doesn't have a place in this world. All they do, because there's sometimes I don't want to spend a lot of money on a big set. One of those big brand name sets, you know, like Lego or Kobe or Mega Bloks or Sluban or Kazi or any of the Chinese brick companies, which really most of them are a lot better quality than BestLock. But BestLock has its place. They're affordable. And if you want to make a video where you're going to blow something up or stomp on it or break it, well, BestLock, they're my number one choice. I hate to really break or destroy something that still has use or value. But I digress. So anyways, it's the last of the sets. And if you remember, how did we get this set? Well, I bought it online at Amazon the first time. Yeah, I had to buy this twice. All of the jets in this product line, you know, the Alaska Airlines jets, the Southwest, the United, all these jets sell for between $5 and $11 or $12-ish dollars. They're affordable, they're cool, they're collectible. They have very cool stickers on them, and they come with a minifig. The minifig, you really can't use it with a set, but, you know, if you buy 14 jets, you'll have 14 minifigs that you can do whatever you want with them, so I guess that's pretty cool. And the minifigs come already built. Unlike a lot of the Chinese sets, we have to assemble your minifig, which I hate to do. At least these minifigs, they already come assembled. The problem is, every minifig is the same. If I'm buying one for Alaska Airlines, and then United Airlines, and then we'll say Qantas, how come they don't put a little sticker on each minifig? It says, it's a pilot minifig, I am from Alaska Airlines, or I'm from Southwest, or I'm from Delta, or I'm from US Air. I don't know. I'd have done a better job with it. Well, then again, if I was Daron, I would have never teamed up with BestLock. I've made no secrets of that. That's why we call it WorstLock. Now, don't get me wrong, this video is not just about bashing BestLock, because I have plenty of BestLock sets. They made the Terminator sets, which were so-so quality, still had their problems, but at least they made Terminator sets. They didn't do very well, and they're all in the markdown bin. So I buy this the first time online, Amazon. I don't remember what I paid for it, but it was about what all the others cost. And I bought a Continental jet, I think, at the same time. And then I said, hey, don't I have the Continental jet? I couldn't find it. And then I couldn't find the Qantas jet. I finally found the Continental jet, and then we did the video with it. And I'm not sure, but I think my lovely assistant actually ordered me another Continental jet while we were looking for the first one. And I don't know which one came first, the one in the mail or the one we found, but we had two of them. But neither I nor one of my lovely assistants was able to find the Qantas jet. We looked everywhere, but that's not to say it's still, it's probably still there. We have mountains and mountains of stuff we haven't gotten to. Then there's the mountains of stuff we've already gotten to, but we can't get rid of until I post the video. Just in case the computer crashes. And if the computer crashes and I lose all my data and I have to film it again, then I don't have to buy the thing again. So I ordered another Qantas jet, or I tried. I looked all over and I couldn't find it. They were out of stock everywhere. Amazon, Alibaba, eBay, and I hate eBay. I just hate eBay. I don't even want to deal with eBay, but I was going to deal with eBay, but they were out of stock there, too. So I decided I'm going to look at Qantas websites. And the first Qantas website, I thought it was the official site. They had all kind of Qantas gear there. They didn't have this. I said, oh, bummer. So I did some more searches for this jet in Australia and New Zealand, and I came up with some kind of New Zealand kind of Craigslist sort of thing. And every time I said buy, it locked me out, or the page would freeze up or go blank. So I'm guessing it may not have been open to international sales, or it might have been an old one. I don't know. It wasn't working. So I gave up. And then a couple weeks later, I said, I'm going to try it again. And then I found another Qantas website that says it's the official website. And sure enough, it was, because I got there via their purchase ticket place. And that's not to say the first one that said we have official Qantas gear wasn't an official site. It just wasn't the official Qantas website. So, and sure enough, they had it in stock, and it was only $16.35. I said, $16.35? That's more than I paid for any of these, but it's worth it. I need this jet. I've already bought it once, and as soon as we do the Qantas jet, we're done with all of these. And really, I hate these jets. These jets are an amazing concept. They just weren't, I don't know, it wasn't implemented well. Daron teamed up with BestLock, horrible BestLock quality, and I hate stickers, but stickers is the only redeeming value of these sets. The stickers are hard to put on. They run the entire length of the jet. They're horrible to put on, but when you got them on, it looks good. Even wrinkly and horrible, the stickers make these sets, because you can have the gaps and the bricks and the ones not going together and the dirt and the smudge. It doesn't matter. The stickers cover up all of that. Except the stickers that you wrap around the engines, the motors there, that's a bad idea. We did that in a couple jets, but other than that, horrible idea. If Daron would have teamed up with any other company in the world, even one of those Chinese brick companies like a Sluban, they would have done a lot better job than with BestLock. So I had to collect all of these because we started the collection, right? I wanted you guys to see what they all look like. And you remember my motto, I buy the junky brick sets so you don't have to, because I can buy these sets and I can say, hey, they really aren't junk, you should get them. Or I can buy these sets, I can say, hey, these are junk, but the price is good. If you want to get them, get them. So I buy the junk so you don't have to. Ow. A fly attacking me here. Oh, a mosquito. I hope it's not carrying one of those weird, ow, mosquito diseases. That wasn't the mosquito biting me. That was the mosquito coming close to me and me just trying to smack it and just smacking myself instead. So this is the last of the jets, and I am glad we are done. So $16.35, and that was $16.35 Australian, which you do the math currently. Now these, you know, prices, currency prices fluctuate, and they go back and forth. But the $16.35 Australian is only $12.92 US. And then I'm getting the checkout. And you can see here, I get the checkout, and they want $56 shipping and handling. $56? I know things cost more in Australia, but are you kidding me? And I was going to buy two of the jets so I could have one just in case, because, you know, it was so hard to get. And I said, no, I'm not going to buy two. So I redid it and took one of them off. And the shipping and handling didn't go down. It was still $56. Well, in their defense, that's $56 Australian, which is only $44.24 US. But still, $44 for a $12.92 toy? Are you insane? But what was my choice? I've been looking for it for months. I've been looking for the one I already have for months. If I didn't just spend this money and get it done with, oh, I was hoping I can get this wrapped up before 2015. But obviously I didn't, because it's 2015 and you're just now seeing this video. For a grand total on this $72.35, that's Australian, so it's really only $57.15. $57.15 for this? Are you insane? Well, yeah, but it looks a little better when you compare it. It could have been $72.35. Now, the current conversion rate as of today. Now, this isn't as of when I ordered this, because I ordered this on November 1st, so the conversion rate could have been actually worse. But as of today, one Australian dollar is about 79 U.S. cents, or 0.79 U.S. dollars. One U.S. dollar is now $1.27, and you're going to laugh because it took me, I don't know, 5 minutes to do all these conversions. When I started the conversion, it was only $1.26. When I was done, it was $1.27. So that's currency values are just always moving. So, it could have been this back on November 1st, or it could have been something totally different, but this is a pretty good ballpark. So, it's $57 US for this, or $72.35 Australian. Oh, my. But that's what it took to wrap this up. And then there's another problem. If you see the date, November 1st, it took 2 months for me to get this. 2 months. Qantas. You know, they're a jet airline company, like United Airlines, or Southwest, or Delta. Qantas! 2 months to get this from Australia to the west coast of the United States. Why didn't they just give it to one of the Qantas employees who's on the plane and say, here, put this in your pocket. When you get to the U.S., mail it to this dude. It would have got here a lot quicker. You're an airline company. It takes 2 months to get me something. Man, that's insane. But if you fly in and out of Australia, you gotta fly Qantas. I'm sure you can fly somebody else, but you know, Qantas, you know, you gotta fly Qantas if you're in Australia. Sometimes you don't have a choice. And there's something else that scared me too. When I ordered this, I couldn't remember if it was a Boeing 747 Qantas jet. So, in the first one, I couldn't tell you if it was an A380 or a 747. So over those several months, about 6 months of me doing online searches looking for one of these Qantas jets, I kept seeing it pop up as an A380. I said, I don't want an A380, but if I have to, I'll get it, because I already have A380s. I only have one 747, the Air Force One. And I prefer a Boeing plane over an Airbus plane. Anyway, that's a whole other story. Anywho's, but even when I clicked on to buy that A380 Qantas jet, they were out of stock, or it locked up, or it didn't exist. Oh, man. So fast forward several months. After November 1st, when I ordered this, and I couldn't find my receipt right away, I was still doing searches for Qantas jets just to see if anybody had a bunch in stock, and I'd get some more because they're so hard to get, and I'm paying so much for it. And you know, it kept coming up A380. I didn't see any 747s. And I know I mentioned this in a previous video. I said, oh, that Qantas jet's coming. I hope it's not an A380. Oh, but then, yes, it was a 747, so I was really glad about that. So it took 2 months to get, it cost an arm and a leg, and at least it's a 747, and at least, dun 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 dun, it's the last one of these we will ever have to build or look at ever again. Yeah, until they start making more, right? And we have put together a lot of these Daron BestLock jets, and really, if I had not have discovered these, I wouldn't have discovered the very cool little Daron diecast jets. Amazing detail, they're great, I love them. And I have a couple videos with the jets, and I have another little video I'm going to do with a Q400. Another cool jet, or a jet, airplane that I fly on all the time. But they're really not to scale. The Q400 is almost to scale with a 737, but the UPS 747 I have is about the same size as the Alaska 737. Really? A 747? That thing should be twice as big. It's huge. Well, it's not super huge. I mean, it's not an A380 or a C-5 Galaxy or a C-17 Globemaster or something, or that big Russian plane which landed at the airport where I worked one time. But still, they're big planes. Jets, not planes. Sorry. So it was kind of a bummer that Daron didn't have that to scale, because that would have just been icing on the cake, because they're very detailed, they're very cool, and they're fun to play with. A lot of playability. And these have some playability. You can do a lot of things with these planes. Previous videos, I said you can hang from the ceiling and make a mobile, you can put them on the shelf, you can fly them around, you can throw them. They don't fly very well, we've tried that, but we'll make a couple videos with them. But I am just glad we are done with these. And I'm glad I finally have a Qantas jet with a little kangaroo on the back. Yeah, it's kangaroo, it's not a wallaroo, it's a kangaroo on the back. But very cool, glad I finally found it, even though it cost me a lot of money. And you guys are glad that I found it, because now you won't have to watch any more of these Daron BestLock horrible quality passenger jets. At least that's the plan, unless they start making more, right? All right, so what do you think? Do you have some of these? I know several of you have some of these. You're not collecting all of them like I am, but you've collected a couple because you get them at airport gift shops, or you get them online, or you have them in toy stores. You say, wow, you know, I'll get a couple of these. You know, I fly Southwest. I like flying Southwest, or I fly United. Look at the United Airlines one, or the Continental. It's very cool. And you've experienced the same things I have. Blemishes in the brakes, the horrible clutching, horrible stickers. Horrible to put on stickers, but amazingly cool looking stickers. And in every video I say, well, if you don't want to put the stickers on, maybe you can do a custom paint job with it. But really, a custom paint job would be wasted on a brick jet of this quality. You'd do better to buy the Kobe 737, do a custom paint job on that. Or even one of those Airfix quick build jets or planes, then custom paint that up. Very cool. But we are finally done with these, and I am glad. And by no means am I trying to deter anybody from buying any of these, especially if you get them for under $10 all day long. A lot of them shipped from London originally, so I got jets for $10 and $8 and $7 shipped all the way from England. But most of my later ones came from the U.S. from the Amazon's warehouse. So they're a good deal if you want a jet, but they're just not going to be good quality. You might want to keep a little thing of super glue when you're putting them together. It's just how it is. So what do you think? Are you guys as happy as I am that we are done with these jets? I am. So leave your comments in the comment section. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Tell me how you really feel. And hey, as always, thanks for watching.
We are filming.
Okay.
22, the most dangerous man on YouTube.